Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner, and I am available for code reviews and on-site training. And in this episode, we need to talk about padding, what it is, and why you might care. I guess I should probably also mention alignment, because that's actually incredibly relevant to this conversation. So let's change the episode title to What Are Padding and Alignment and Why You Might Care? This episode is sponsored by JetBrains. Besides yourself, who knows your project best? Your IDE. This is what makes AI Assistant and CLion, a C++ IDE by JetBrains, so context-aware and helpful. Wondering how to adopt C++ modules into your project or link to a selected library in CMake? Send your question to the AI chat. Its answer will take into account the technology you use and your project context. Need to research an error? AI Assistant and CLion can explain a runtime error, a CMake execution failure, or a selected piece of code. Want to improve your code? AI Assistant will suggest a refactoring and generate documentation for you. Learn more at jb.gg/cbp_AI. Okay, so let's take a quick look at alignment to start with. Okay, so there's this standard library thing called alignment of, and I can ask it, what is the alignment of a type? And this is returning to me the value 4. And what this basically means is that integers must be on 4-byte boundaries. So let's create a fake little memory map here. We have this. An int can live here. It can live at the 0th memory location. And it's possible for an int to live at the 4th and at the 8th. That is the basics of alignment. Now, someone is going to come in and say, but yes, you can pack the structs. Yeah, but packing the structs is actually outside of the C and C++ standards, and that relies on compiler specific behavior. And it also often generates less efficient code. So unless you think you're using packed structs correctly, hint, you probably aren't, and yes, I'm just going to leave that out there, go ahead and leave a comment saying that I'm throwing out there that you're probably using packed structs incorrectly, get annoyed, leave the comment, it's fine. I don't have time to go into it right now. But this is the fundamentals of alignment. So if I ask for the alignment of a car, that's going to be 1. Now let's go ahead and ask it the alignment of a long. That's a 64-bit integer. And its alignment is 8. Now you see where I'm going with this. Certain types can only live at certain memory locations for the compiler to generate good, efficient code that follows the C and C++ standards. This also is necessary for things like standard layout types so that you can interoperate with C code so that we know this layout. Okay, so now we're going to get to the part of why do you care? Let's just go ahead and make our own little struct as I often like to do on this channel. And I'm going to do something like this. I've got, let's see, this is going to be 1 byte. This is going to be 4 bytes. I'm on a 64-bit platform, and it's not required by the standard, but I know that ints are 4 bytes wide, characters are 1 byte wide, long is 8 byte wide, and character 1 byte wide. Okay, so this should theoretically be 19. This is 19 bytes worth of data. Let's go ahead and use the size of operator to ask the compiler what the size of the struct is. And we can see it is 32 bytes. So I have wasted 13 bytes per object of type S that I create. And if you've got a lot of these things and you're looking at nearly 100% overhead, well, okay, I'm exaggerating. It's a very high overhead. What is that? 75% overhead? That's a lot of overhead. But you might say, but this is logically, this makes sense for how my code should be accessed. And I'm not going to disagree with you. But this brings us to the part of why we might care about padding. Now, the point being, so this can live on the zeroth byte, but now this can't live on byte one. It has to get to the next alignment that is allowed for an integer, and that is going to be 4. And then this can live on byte 5 because that is an alignment of 1. And then this has to have its alignment start on 8. So that is 3 bytes wasted, 3 bytes wasted. And then this one is going to end at 12, which means this one has to start at 16 because it has an alignment of 8. And then this character can have its memory address start at 25. So the rest of this is padding to round the thing out to an allowed size for the total object. So if I comment that out, we get to 24. Note, adding that one last character jumps this thing up to 32 bytes. Again, what do we do about this? Let's go ahead and just kind of do a little bit of, shall we say, manual packing. Pretend like we're playing Tetris with our types here, and put all the characters up front and then add in the integers and then add in that long. And if I do something like that, then I only get 1 byte wasted here and 0 bytes wasted between the two integers and another 4 bytes wasted. And well, you can see how this is starting to play out. But I just shrunk the size of this thing by 8 bytes by simply rearranging the layout of it. Okay, let's go ahead and go back to this, and I'm going to remove my comments so we're not confusing things too much, but I'm going to make the situation as bad as possible. And we're going to point out that there is a compiler diagnostic on most compilers that gives you some sort of padding warning. Now, GCC doesn't have it, but Clang, I see padded, not padding, is going to give us some things here. So it tells me I'm padding struct S on line 19 with 3 bytes to a line I. Oh, look, you're right. Let's go ahead and shift that down a wee bit and see if we can get anything here. Okay, on line 20, I'm doing another padding. Let's see if I can shift that down. Well, we have a pretty good idea what the optimal layout would look like once we start looking at it. Although we're still going to get some padding warnings. We're going to see that there's a padding of 1 byte here to align that I, and then we're going to see that there's a padding of 4 bytes to align L. And I have warnings as errors. So we can't enable W padded all the time. That's not going to give us meaningful information all the time because there's a lot of use cases where padding is necessary. So just a few best practices comments here. Use the W padded warning from time to time to find padding. Don't use it all the time. Only use it when you think you can learn something useful from it. But as we can see here, there's no way to quote fix these issues. This is just the nature of this particular struct. And be aware of how struct and class layout might affect your code and your cache. And finally, if you need to rearrange the members to try to fix some sort of alignment issue, you will break your ABI, so please be aware of that if this is production code with binary libraries that have been shipped long ago or something like that. And again, thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe, leave it a thumbs up.